Oh! drives you of the key to salvation, are you willing to give your life to Him? What did He say? I shall return.
Yeah.
And what did Jesus say? I shall return.
Yeah.
Hallelujah, baby. And we're here to serve the Lord Jesus Christ. But Pastor Christ, my brothers and sisters, the Lord Jesus touched many policemen in their lives. I even think now when I was seeing us praising the Lord and lifting our hands to heaven, I think the Lord was training policemen when He said, put your hands up. He was training them. Praise the Lord. Woo! Glory to God. But you know, the Lord has been using policemen in the areas where sin is multiplying. The Lord is touching the hearts of the police officer who are becoming born again Christians. When we reach out, we see one that's committing a violation of crime. We just don't write out summonses anymore. We give Him trials. We pray with Him. Hallelujah. The miracles that are happening. The miracles that are happening, we see, and I saw myself. I retired from a police department last year. But I didn't end there. I'm serving my Lord Jesus Christ. He opened doors for me to go out into the field. Teach me your word. Hallelujah. Oh, praise the Lord God. You know, John 3:16. Praise God. We all know this famous one, and I'll read it verse to verse. For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth on Him, in Him, shall not perish but have everlasting life. But it didn't end there. It said, for God sent His Son into the world not to condemn, but through Him might be saved.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Not to condemn, but to go out and preach the word to the world to be saved.
Yeah.
Council Christ had an opportunity, the Lord opened the doors for us to witness it to, of all places, the prisons. In the prisons where these men, our hearts are open and need the word, and the most important thing that you have up there is love.
Yeah.
Love.
That's it.
The Lord Jesus Christ puts the love in our hearts as Christians.
Yeah.
They'll know us by our love.
Yeah.
And one example that we reached out into the Nassau County prisons and many, many other areas. The Lord opened the door for us, my brother here, myself, and others, to reach in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania,
yeah,
a prison, a state penitentiary.
Oh, with my shield on.
All right.
See, but this shield kept me in the subway. And this shield will get me in heaven.
All right.
With this shield, I can lock up a criminal. With this shield, I can lock up a cancer.
Hey!
With this shield, I can bust tuberculosis.
Yep.
Hallelujah. Glory be to God. You see, we got a spiritual shield that's got more power than a physical shield. Glory be to God.
Thank you.
get home and prepare a lot of time. Come on, tell him, come on.
Thank you. of anything else that could be happening. We were God. Yeah. He's a prince of rebellion. You don't expect anything different from him tonight. But we're not here to talk about him. I'd like to introduce a brother from across New Jersey who God used to start a group of Christian officers called the God Squad. They're back in the New Jersey. And I want you to please be careful of this, to listen to when he said what his definition of a cop is. Praise the Lord. Amen.
You know, many brother officers come up to us and they ask us, well, who's Christ? Who's God? I remember there was an article in the New York Times a couple weeks ago that said that the Christ is here. So that generated a lot of questions. Let me just say this to you. That I know who my Christ is, I know who my God is, because when he returns, he's splitting that sky from east to west, and he's coming down to the This is how we will know who the ever-living God is. Police officers. The book of Ephesians chapter 4, verse 11 says he gave some apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, some pastors, some teachers, and some cops in the end time. Cops are going out. Cops are going to go out, and they're not only armed with pistols and badges and billy clubs, but we're armed with the full armor of the ever-living God, Jesus Christ. And cops, COP, Christians on the road, that's what it's called. With Christian cops, when people get arrested, yes, they're going to get fingerprinted. Yes, their photograph's going to get taken. But as long as we're on duty, they're going to hear the word of the ever-living God. Two weeks ago, there was a man in a cell. And I was on my way home, walking downstairs from my office. And the Holy Spirit of God just stopped me in my tracks. And God told me to go downstairs into my office and to take a New Testament and to go into the cell and to give it to this man, to give this man the Word of God and to tell him that he will be set free, that God Almighty will set him free. And I talked to this man and he said, I can't accept it. He says, right now I can't. I felt ejected. I felt a little drawn back. But then I heard a whisper. A whisper from a 19-year-old boy in another cell. And he said, Officer, hand me that Bible. Pray for your pastors in these end days. Pray for Christian cops in these end days. And guess what? I'll meet you at the banquet.
But I thank God for allowing me to be on this police force because it is He that gave me the job. Because we are confronted every day with situations that the average citizen does not confront. We're with the best, we're with the worst, we're with the rich, we're with the poor, we're with the meek, we're with the proud. And praise God, I thank Him for what He's done in my life. He's changed my life. He's given me a new heart. Not a heart of stone, but a heart of His love and compassion. A heart that reaches out beyond your mother's love. A heart that reaches out beyond your wife, beyond your husband, beyond your children's love. A Lord that reaches the hearts of people, of men and women. And I thank God for what He's doing. I thank God because there are opportunities every day that we come against. We're fighting against spirits. We're fighting against wicked spirits in higher places. We're fighting against rulers. We're not fighting against what someone says. It's a spirit. And I thank God because God still learning and growing. Still going to make mistakes. We still have to go through the trials and tests and tribulations in order to be understanding of the Lord's ways. There's some things that we don't understand. There's some things we're not going to understand. His ways are not our ways. His thoughts are not our thoughts. But I thank God for what He's doing. I thank God. Today, I was confronted this morning on a call of a DOA, that is the person who's dead on arrival. And when you begin, when God begins to deal with you, you look at things through His eyesight. He begins to show you things with His heart that He's given you, that new heart. And there was a paraplegic. And she just couldn't have, a paraplegic is one who cannot move the body, they're just immobile. And she was just in the bed. Her mother had just passed away last night. And somehow she's living in a hotel apartment where the phone, they can unplug it. And it was unplugged. And here her mother had caught a heart attack or a stroke and hit her head. And she was laying there helplessly and could not do anything. And until the next day someone came in. When God begins to deal with you and you begin to see through His eyesight the things that are going on around us, it just makes you thank God. It makes you want to praise Him more and get along with Him more. And sure, it's not every day that I read the Bible, but I'm striving for that. I'm still human. We all will make mistakes. But let us look to the Lord Jesus from where our help coming from. It's important that we just look at the Lord and look at what He's doing. Read His word and get along and pray and fast and seek this. There's so many things going on that God has shown me now. We're dealing out here with these people that people don't understand. But God is real. And believe me, His power is real. And I just want to give all the praise to God. And I thank the pastors and ministers of this day for allowing us to come this day. God bless you. Amen.
The Madison Square Garden many times. And most times it's the devil having some kind of party here. Can you imagine how many demons had to run out of this place? You know, I thank the Lord that I met Him at an early age because my mother and father were Christians. And that was important to my mom and dad. If you're an example, your children will come to know the Lord. But you know, I never wanted to be a cop. I was going to be a minister. I was going to Bible school. In fact, the best thing I got out of Bible school was my wife. I took the test to be a cop because I was going to college to be a teacher. My uncle wanted me to go. But you know something? Whatever happens, and I'm going to speak to the young people tonight, there's a leading of God in your life. You may not end up where you want to be. But God has a reason for you being in a certain place. And let me tell you tonight, as a police officer, when I first came on the job, I saw a part of life I had never seen before. I saw sin head on. You know, while we sleep at night, there are people all over our city who are in trouble. Who's out there? The pastor can't be out there 24 hours a day. The evangelist and so on. But God gives people taps them on the shoulder, whether they be cops. I've seen them riding on ambulances. I've seen them on train conductors. I've seen little old black ladies at Grand Central giving out tracts in the middle of the night. God will provide somebody. Somebody once asked me, and many of you are probably asking the same question, how could you be a cop and a Christian? You know, if it wasn't for the police, you wouldn't be here tonight. Because in the New Testament, when the people first got saved, they got very comfortable in Jerusalem. And God had to send the police after them and chase them all over the world. But you know something else? Jesus spoke many times and crowds gathered. And he performed miracles. But you know something else? The scene of all these crowds. And you and I know tonight, you couldn't have been around the Lord without something happening to you. No matter what reason you were there. There are people here tonight because they have to work here. But you know something? They're being exposed to the Lord Jesus Christ. And I pray that you be saved. Do you think that a man or a woman could have been the same as a police officer or a correction officer after being handcuffed to a man like Paul or Silas? Could a man have been watching the prison when he hears these Christians singing and be the same man again? The Word of God also shows that the first man to get saved who wasn't a Jew happened to be a cop by the name of Cornelius. He was a Roman police guy.